the audience of the one. When talking about science and life in general, opposite attracts, but it's not the same case when talking about God and man. Like attracts like, because man was crafted after the image and the likeness of God, our creator. A man's spirit bears the same DNA which God breathed into Adam, and the man became a living soul. The spirit of man is the candle of the Lord, searching all the inward parts of the belly. Ever wondered why we hate hearing the truth about our souls and God? The spirit of God has been patiently standing next to you and earnestly and gently blowing the dimmed candle of your soul. You see, the mind is telling you that you're nothing more than just a blob of flesh and blood. And you believe the lie, and yet you can't explain why you remain confused and agitated within. No matter what a man does, he cannot extricate himself from himself, what he really is. The two-mind thing going off at the same time has been triggered by the spirit within, yearning for God. God designed your life and based it on two levels. Your mind upstairs and your spirit on lower level. The spirit of God constantly reaches out to your heart through the still small voice. This is the consciousness of man located deep within your belly. The audience of the one is what it is from the very beginning. It began with God, the Godhead thinking to themselves, let us make man in our image and our likeness. After literally crafting Adam with his own hands, God was impressed that Adam was still nothing but a lifeless effigy. Adam's body was 100% earth composite and 0% God. The audience of the one is the audience of the one and only true and wise God. God breathed a portion of himself inside Adam's lifeless body, and thus the man became a living soul. You see, unlike man, it is impossible for God to let out a part of himself and later reclaim that part by way of repossession. He hath showed thee, O man, what is good, and what doth the Lord require of thee, but to do justly, and to love mercy, and to walk humbly with thy God. The audience of the one is always man desperately trying to argue with himself in his fruitless attempt to disapprove and reject God. Shadows and footprints is when Adam tried to run and hid himself from God. The audience of the one. Adam got violently scared in his heart as the giant black clouds of sin and condemnation overwhelmed his soul with guilt. Would you believe or curse me if I told you that God didn't chase Adam, but the man tried to run away from his own shadows and footprints? With God there's no shadow of turning. A man's shadows and footprints will testify against man's guilt at the judgment day. This is what baffles many and ask puzzling questions like, how is it possible for God to find me within a crowd of 8 billion souls in the world today? O foolish man thou art! Did you not know that your shadows and footprints are actually the footage of your heart and soul, spattered all over the vegetation of God? You can't run away from yourself. Everything you do or say gets attracted inside the pages of our lives, the conscious. The audience of the one. Can you now see and understand just how easy it will be for God to deal with all the myriads of souls from Adam to the last day of this world at the judgment day? Just like Adam, sinners will automatically group themselves to the left-hand side of Christ the Judge, without the angels of God marshalling the crowds. The audience of the one. Condemned sinners will worship God and bow before Christ, saying, thou Lord, rule with justice, as they file themselves into the lake of fire. For it is written, every knee shall bow to me, and every tongue shall confess to God. No sinner will ever query and challenge Christ after uttering these sad words. Then shall he say also unto them on the left hand, depart from me, ye cursed, into everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. Wherefore we, receiving a kingdom which cannot be moved, let us have grace, whereby we may serve God acceptably with reverence and godly fear. The audience of the one. There's only God and I this side of heaven.